started. Now it's 3rd and 10.
When we talk about Luke Kuechly, you can't talk about his overall game without talking about his intelligence and how he controls the whole defense. He quarterbacks that defense, and at times will actually make checks just like a quarterback would on offense to get them into the right defense. They definitely were on that play. How about that finish? Holding that to a minimal gain.
Back to throw, Beathard. Now the ball comes loose. I'll call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill, but the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground, whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you retain possession, that's all you're looking for.
They'll throw here. Beathard got his target, Pierre Garçon. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you're rebuilding, we know you got to hit it big in the draft, but you also want to acquire free agents. They're going to really set the tone for your team. Pierre Garçon had some history with head coach Kyle Shanahan previously. I think that's why they picked him up.
He's got great history in this league, of course, starting with the Colts, then the Redskins, now the Niners. On second down, Hyde, and nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1.
That man has still got it. Thomas Davis can do it all. Drop into coverage, rush the quarterback, and, of course, make plenty of tackles.
Closing in on 1,000 career tackles and consistent. Last year, 106 tackles. The year before, 105.
College safety turned linebacker in the NFL. What a career.
And Robinson with a big catch. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. Pretty solid start for the rookie here on this first drive, Charles.
Able to have some confidence, stepping back into the pocket, move around a little bit, find open receivers, and deliver. That just means his confidence is going to continue to grow because he's getting more and more comfortable with each completed pass.
First down, a run with Hyde. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play there, 2nd down. And when you're running the football, one thing you don't want to see is a big boy coming up there to swallow you whole in those D tackles and nose tackles.
No, you're actually counting on your big boys to protect you from them. But on that play, the defensive tackle had the leverage, and he won the battle. No gain, correct?
No gain. Again, it's Hyde. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. It's a gain of about 3, but it's going to leave him with 3rd and still 7 yards to go. And the defense searches for one more stop here after the run on 2nd down.
Here we go now. Blue liner.
Here's Beathard to throw. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Thomas Davis. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So the first interception of his career under center, and you knew it was going to happen sooner or later.
It has to. And I know he feels like the world is just tumbling down at this moment, but there's got to be some veteran somewhere, some mentor that's going to tell him, hang in there, my man. Plenty more to come. Keep firing.
NFL carry for the rookie Christian McCaffrey. Give him 12 yards on that one. It earns him a fresh set of downs. Somewhat surprising stat. The Panthers, they haven't had a 1,000-yard rusher on the ground since 09. That's the longest active drought in the NFL, but certainly they're hoping Christian McCaffrey can change that.
Not just as a ball carrier, but also as a pass receiver and take pressure off of Cam Newton, give him some easy completions, and maybe he doesn't get hit as much in the pocket that way.
Back to the ground on first. It's McCaffrey. Oh, and now he bowls him over. And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Newton to throw. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. No gain on the screen there. It's second down.
So many screen passes are the result of excellent acting by everyone. But sometimes the guy who's getting the ball tips the play off. Yeah, the running back, because he's eager to get the pass. And sometimes he doesn't act very well about whether he's going to block or leak out or whatever. And I think that they saw that, and that's why they're able to get to him on it.
Now it's Newton. Got a man. It's the rookie, Curtis Samuel. And he's brought down after a good gain. 23 yards on the play.
One of the feature points of the in route is being able to make a nice throw to the middle part of the field. And for a quarterback, that's one of the better throws and better looks that he'll get. But he has to be careful not to wait too long and let his receiver wander into some tough territory. If he's late with the ball, he can get his receiver hit and hit hard.
Now whistles. Flag down, and I believe one of the Panthers got moving early. McCaffrey following the penalty. Oh, he breaks a tackle and he's got an alley. 20, 10, 5. A big play there for Carolina. 57 yards on the ground. So down inside the 5-yard line, I have to say, really just a poor job defensively there.
You're exactly right. As a former defensive back, that was not played well at all. But give credit to the offense and give credit to the guy running the football. He gets it down all the way inside the 5.
Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. Throwing is Newton. And that'll be caught. Panthers touchdown. It's Benjamin with a grab. Kelvin Benjamin from 4 yards out. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. And this will be good to give the Panthers a 7-0 lead. Now to kick this one away. This is fielded at the chalk of the 10. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. The 49ers heading out. And Charles, at the end of last year, we talked about their decline. They were 12-4 4 years ago, then 8-8, 5-11, and last season 2-14. Head coaches, four of them the last 4 years. But while it may not change overnight, you get the sense the tailspin may be over.
Agreed with you there, partner, because they change administration as well. And they're going to respect the pass. They want all these players coming in to know what the 49ers meant in previous years. They want them to make their own future. And this is their opportunity now. How about them picking up Solomon Thomas in the draft, the defensive lineman out of Stanford? How about them getting Reuben Foster, the linebacker out of Alabama, trying to get stronger on defense? They'll run a brand new offensive scheme, and they will be a tougher team overall. I think they're going to compete well in the NFC West, better than what people expect.
Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
Look, Carolina had a number of issues last year, and that's why they slumped to 6-10 after a Super Bowl appearance. But pass rush wasn't a problem for them. They still got to the quarterback.
47 total sacks. That was just one behind Arizona, who led the league.
Yeah, I think the biggest issue for them, young corners, they gave up a lot of big plays.
The Niners on third down. They've been okay, 2-for-3 thus far. This is 3rd and 9. To throw is Beathard. And that is incomplete.
It's a great job by this secondary. When I watch them, they remind me of elite defenders on a basketball court, right? They want to contest each and every pass.
Great contest on third down to bring up 4th. And he gets this away, angled for the sideline with a lot behind it. Wow. Out of bounds as he appeared to be looking for the corner. He got it. They're going to mark this at the 4-yard line. Here are the Panthers now as their offense comes back out onto the field. They'll be looking to duplicate that first drive, the one that got them that 7-0 lead.
Of course they would. I mean, look, they're on the road. So getting the 7-0 lead was huge for them, right? Imagine getting up 2 touchdowns on the road, taking the crowd out of the game. It'd be ideal.
And not great starting field position here for the offense. And now whistles here and a flag down. Looked like someone got going a little early. To McCaffrey, and he'll get him a little bit of breathing room across the 5 to the 6-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down.
Well, if the coaching staff's doing a good job upstairs, they'll file away what they just saw from the defense right there. They sold out to stop that running play. I'd say keep that in mind. They want to try that again. Go play action, hit them over the top.
8 yards to go here on second down. Now a first carry for their fullback. And he'll take this forward only up to about the 7. He'll pick up only a yard there, and it'll leave him with a 3rd and 7.
Back-to-back runs, I'd say that encompassed maximum effort for minimal gain.
Minimal yardage, and now they're going to need something more than minimal on this play coming up. And on 3rd down, a nickel formation here defensively. Out of the gun, Newton steps away to his left. And he slides to avoid the hit. Newton able to use those legs and get past the marker to pick up the first.
We just saw a nice example of why teams often bring in baseball guys to teach quarterbacks how to slide in key situations. You want to protect your franchise guy. Make sure he doesn't get hurt. He did exactly that on that play. A perfect slide to avoid the big hit and pick up a first down.
Final 30 seconds of this first quarter, and it's been a quarter dominated by the guys with a football. Now a play fake here on first down. This is caught. It's Greg Olsen. He's at the 50. He's at the 30. The 20. Touchdown, Carolina. Greg Olsen, 84 yards. And the Panthers add on to their lead. You got to figure if they want to have success this year, the more they can put the football in his hands, the better, coming off a Pro Bowl campaign.
And that Pro Bowl campaign does more than just get him notoriety. It also plants an idea in the minds of guys trying to defend him that he's really pretty good, and sometimes gives you a little bit of extra room, a little bit of extra deference, and he's taking advantage of it.
This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. The 49ers getting set to trot out there. Already down 2 touchdowns here in the first half. This becomes a pretty important drive, doesn't it?
It certainly does, and a lot of the teams script plays. We know that, right? They have a script to start the ball game, and typically those scripts go between 12 and 24, 25 plays. Down 2 touchdowns early, probably not very deep into their script. I think that they'll stay with it. I don't think they'll abandon it just yet and try and generate some offense on this drive.
Anything, at least 3 points, get that 0 off the board. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line. Give him 30 yards there. First down and 10 now for the offensive group. Here's Beathard to throw. Deep ball for Goodwin. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on, and it's second down. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary, it really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense. Great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone. And especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to him.
To throw is Beathard. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. It's the Pro Bowl. Kinkley that picks it, and his guys are going to get the football at their own 47-yard line. That's sort of a second quarter to forget for him. Now two picks in this frame.
Almost as if the first one that he threw, he couldn't shake, couldn't get it out of his head. He ends up throwing a second one as a result.
Compounds the mistake a little bit.
Yeah, you got to be able to forget, compartmentalize, whatever you want to call it, and move on. He hasn't been able to do so here in the second.
And very little running room there. He did get a couple up to the 49.
Well, he was looking for some running room, and there wasn't a whole lot of it there on that play. I think he was lucky to get a couple yards out of it because those defenders, they were rallying to the football pretty quickly.
Ground McCaffrey again, and he's going to take this one down inside the 45. Good work to pick up 7 yards there. That gets him into a third and one situation.
That was a good run, and it got to the second level. And what I mean by that is that's where the linebackers usually play, first level being the defensive front, last level being the secondary. But the strong safety position ended up making the tackle, and oftentimes we call them a hybrid combination defensive back, combination linebacker. We saw the linebacker make the stop.
Newton looking to throw on third and one. And he finds a man. It's Olsen. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Newton to Olsen there for a Carolina first down. Off to his running back McCaffrey, and he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and it's a second down. This is McCaffrey looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Not enough there for a first. No gain, as a matter of fact. And it leaves them at third and one. Newton on third down. He's going to find his running back. It's complete. It's a gain of 4, and it gets him the first. This drive, it's been a good mix. 3 passing plays, 3 runs, hitting on all 3 of those passes, and the last one putting him in the red zone.
So wouldn't you think play action right here? Because you've got the ability and had the ability to run it and throw it. Go play action and take your shot at the end zone.
On first down, this is McCaffrey. You can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it 2nd and 4.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball. But when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
On second down, here's Newton. And he is caught at the 7-yard line. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. It's a 10-yard gain there, and it sets him up now first and goal. Shotgun snap for Newton. Buying time to his left. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line. Aaron Lynch able to run him down for a loss of a yard. Second down, McCaffrey. And he's going to get him about 3 yards closer. He's down to about the 2. This is kind of one of those in-between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the 2 or the 3 in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. And if you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hands in a hurry.
The offense on third down, a perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is third and goal. Here's Newton. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's fourth down.
The way he's been slinging it in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's going to have to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't he?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be. So on fourth down, Ron Rivera sends out the field goal unit. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle. And Elliott puts this one through. And the lead will grow. It's now 17-0. And Charles, they get the field goal. Took him a dozen plays, though.
Work with me on this one. You know what I'm about to say, right? Bend but don't break. That's what came into play here for the defense. 12 plays were run at them. They only gave up 3 points. In a lot of ways, that's a win for the defense.
And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Reminder that later tonight, we'll see the Giants and Cowboys battle in Dallas. Seems like they're always playing in Week 1. And then on Monday night, a doubleheader. Adrian Peterson, his first game with the Saints. He's already back in Minnesota to play the Vikings. And then a 10-20 start on the East Coast. It's the first game for the L.A. Chargers traveling to Denver.
A nice AFC West matchup.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Intended receiver Marquise Goodwin, and it's third and short.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
Back to throw. And he can't come up with a pick. Nearly his second of the game. Instead, fourth down.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. Taken in at the 22. He's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Carolina.
And as soon as they hand a rookie his playbook, they say, you better make your mark on special teams if you want to hang around. I'd say returning one for a touchdown will definitely leave a memory.
Yeah, that's a pretty indelible mark here early on in his career. So after surrendering the punt return for a score, let's see what they can do in turn on this kickoff. The 49ers offense making its way back out there. And last drive, three and out. Still a goose egg on the scoreboard. How do they break that goose egg?
They've got to find a way to get the ball in the hands of their playmakers, get them some space, and try and make a first down and get some momentum going. It's been a struggle for them throughout the game, and that three and out on the last possession, that told you just how stalled they are on offense.
So who will step up here? We'll see. Remain here in the first half. My good friend Charles and I right back at you after this. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
Hurry up, here we go. 3-19.
He'll drop to throw. From the left side, caught by Goodwin. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
Here we go now. Green, 39.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Caught left side, Garcon. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. A big play there for the Niners. 42 yards. They go play action here on first down. And it's complete. In the end zone, touchdown 49ers. George Kittle, his first NFL reception, goes for six. And the 49ers make some inroads here on that deficit. Robbie Gould on for the extra point. He's got it, and that makes our score 24-7. To kick it away. This one taken just inside the 10. Solid return, pretty good field position. They'll start at the 32-yard line. The Panthers offense taking the field, and it's a crew, Charles, that really took a big step backward last year because they were coming off their best season in franchise history in 2015, the Super Bowl appearance, 15 wins, I guess really 17 if you count the playoffs, but down to just six last year.
A big drop-off was on offense because in 2015, they drove the ball and they rang the bell, meaning they got into the end zone. They scored 500 points in 2015. Big drop-off in 2016. Unsettled offensive line. Guys were hurt out wide. Couldn't keep everyone healthy. Quarterback didn't play to the same level. But guess what? They're changing that up, going from that boom, boom type of an offense to a little more flash and dash. Christian McCaffrey out of Stanford at running back. Curtis Samuel of Ohio State will be a running back receiver. They expect to get quicker, faster.
Kelvin Benjamin! Touchdown, Carolina! Kelvin Benjamin, already his second touchdown here this opening weekend. And the Panthers are able to grow their lead.
Heard a coach talk about those late in the half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. And And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
The San Francisco offense getting their last-minute instructions before they take over here.
And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you've got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play. It'll be second down. The 49ers now going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. And on second and 10 now. He'll look to throw. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Picked off by James Bradbury. And his guys have got him back at the closing stages of the first half. Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And this is a spot late in the clock near midfield, though. Maybe take a couple chances, see if you get in field goal range.
You do that if you have trust. And this should be a position now where the great ones, they relish this opportunity to try and put points on the board.
Now following the interception, here's Newton. Over the middle, complete to Samuel. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Fresh set of downs here. From the gun, here's Newton. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield, complete. And they'll burn the timeout with 5 seconds left. A chance to try to add 3 points before heading to the locker room. So even though it's first down, here's the field goal unit on now to try to get 3 before halftime. And the kick by Elliott is good. And that'll push the lead from 24 up to 27. So the drive stalls out, but they are able to put 3 points on the board.
Yeah, just a yard or two shorter than an extra point, so no problems converting there.
After the field goal, here's Butker to kick it away. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend. As we send you across the country to Orlando, standing by there, Larry Ridley with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Larry? So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number 3. And this will get out of bounds. No worries there, though. That still goes as a touchback. Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
Third quarter and you've got the lead, you're not ready to go into that 4-minute offense to close the game out, but a running game can really benefit your team right now.
McCaffrey on the counter. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Christian McCaffrey, everybody knows the family pedigree, and they're hoping for a lot of big things from him, aren't they?
He gave great evidence of that while he was at Stanford. Tremendous amount of big plays, whether he was running the ball, catching it, returning kicks, you name it. A lot of people were wondering if he would go at number 8 to the Panthers because he's not a big guy, but his ability to make plays in the open field, Panthers could not pass him up.
Well, the numbers have been good in the passing game and certainly a big reason why they have the lead. But now here, third quarter, maybe go to the run game a little more?
Yeah, perhaps. I mean, after that incompletion, a little credit to the defense for shutting them down on that play. Maybe you try and run the football a little bit more in this spot. But they have to feel good about how they've been throwing it overall.
Now a run with McCaffrey, and maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll wind up being a loss of 2, and they'll be facing a 3rd and 12. From the gun, Newton. Got his target, Samuel. And he's taken down at the 43, but not before picking up the first. They give him 17 yards that time as that'll move the chains. Of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. It'll be a loss of 1, and it'll be 2nd and 11. Defense showing blitz. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. And they'll lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down.
Hey, a lot of points have been scored in this game, but what a nice play by the defense. Stepping up on that one, maybe they'll get things going in their direction after a play like that.
2 running plays, each lose a yard. They'll need to do much better now on 3rd and 12. Operating from the gun, Newton. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. They'll get a couple yards on that one, and that's going to bring up a 4th down.
Whether you're playing West Coast offense or not, one of the maxims of the West Coast offense is you're either throwing a touchdown or a check down. In other words, look for the big shot, but be smart. And I think they did exactly that on that play. They didn't get the 1st down, but they're taking care of the ball well.
Yeah, and being rightly cautious with that lead here in the 2nd half. Yeah, that is much too long. That's into the end zone for a touchback. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the 2nd half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance to turn that into points on the offensive end.
Can you imagine what the grease board looks like at the half?
Because tell me.
That's exactly what they printed up. Stop them on defense, get the ball back for our offense, and go downfield and score some points. Now, the last part remains to be seen, but they got the first part done very well.
Do people use grease boards, or you mean the magic marker boards?
Yeah, those two.
Here's Hyde as they begin on the ground. Fights forward for only about a yard. To the 21.
Crash, crash, crash. Run, 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 and run it.
second down following the run.
I got it up, Philly. Here we go. Hurry up. Here we go. Green 39. Green 39.
Well, now they'll try the end around. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs.
When teams have a tough time running the ball, as this one has throughout this game, it's so easy to just say, forget it, let's throw the football. But that's exactly why you stay with the running game. Eventually, you stick with it, you make some adjustments, you often find ways to run the ball better as the game goes on.
So the run gets them the first, and now they operate with a fresh set of downs. Here's Hyde, and he's got some space here. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. It's another 10 yards on that one and another first down.
I think we saw some of the best qualities of Carlos Hyde on that run, able to pick up something there, being physical running the football. But I think he's got really good vision and great feet. He's going to be the key to this offense really being revitalized.
And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground.
Watching that body, body. Hurry up, here we go. Green.
They'll run with a backup. This is Williams. And this time the yards won't come so easy as they'll, in fact, tackle him behind the line. It'll be a loss of a yard, and that'll bring up a second and 11. Stop behind the line of scrimmage. They'll lose a yard, and it brings up third.
We got three. Three down. Three down. Hey, fellas, we got three. Let's go.
The last two plays each lose a yard. They'll try to move forward here on third and 12. Now flags will come in. I think this one's going to be on the defense for jumping. And he got a little aggressive too early.
And he did, wanting that quick takeoff as the ball was snapped. But I think sometimes those big guys on offense, they're pretty cagey too, right? They make those little sudden moves or those little subtle moves that get you to jump.
The Niners on third down, 2 for 5 to this point. This is third and 7.
All right, here we go. Over, 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 over.
Here's Beathard to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
We're into the second half now, and this is an offense that continues to struggle to sustain a drive.
Looks like they're just totally out of sync, whether they're running the ball, passing the ball like we saw there. I don't know. The rhythm seems off. He gets this away as he'll wisely, I'd say, angle this to the sideline. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. They've got the lead. Last time had to punt it, though. What's the key to this drive?
I think it's leverage.
Ah,
the
leverage.
Big guys up front. You know the motivational speech on the sideline is, guys, give us an opportunity. Protect the passer, create space for our runners, and let's go ahead and get these guys. Low man wins. Let's go do it on this drive.
We'll watch that leverage on this drive. This is McCaffrey. And not too much going there as he'll get it up to the 23-yard line. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about 7 here on third down.
And that last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So how has he done it? Because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
Throwing on third down, Newton. He'll drop it off to McCaffrey, and he's going to get to the 31, enough for the first down. They get 9 out of that one, and as a result, the drive continues. Newton on first down. Caught left side by Funchess. Whoa! Still, Funchess is free. 30, past the 20. And he will take it across for a Panthers touchdown. Devin Funchess, 69 yards. And the Panthers just continue to pour it on.
You have fun with this one, partner.
I am. He's been fun to watch under center.
We always talk about, you know, getting to the next level, right? When we see people get into the zone, this guy's in the master class right now. What a performance he's putting on, just carving them up.
4 touchdown passes, carving them up is right. Seems like everything he throws is going to be a completion and going in the end zone. Now a hit and a loose football. And it's picked up by the Panthers. And he takes it into the end zone. It's a fumble recovery and a touchdown for the Panthers. So they get the one score, kickoff, get a fumble, take it right back to the house. 2 quick touchdowns within a matter of about 10 seconds on the game clock.
It's like a big 1-2 punch that may lead to a knockout.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. This one taken just inside the 10. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The 49er offense now making their way out onto the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut it, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault. But hey, listen, there's got to be casualties at times. We're trying to win a game.
He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
You get a tight end like this, and you know he's used to dishing out punishment, but here, he's the one that has to absorb the contact, and as a result, unable to hold on to the football.
Offense still needing 10 yards, second down. And on the outside, they're playing press coverage. To throw is Beathard. This one complete, right side to McDonald. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one goes for 24 yards. And now a first down following that long gain. And some extras coming up on the line here, readying for the blitz. They'll run it now out of the gun. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Back now here in Santa Clara. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. Second down, offense behind the sticks here, second and 13. Back to throw, Beathard. He dumps it to Hyde. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Play fake here on first down. Out to the flat for Hyde. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 20-yard line. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you just swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. And that'll be incomplete. We do have a penalty flag down, however. Let's see what that's about. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
To throw is Beathard. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. Another wayward pass. You know, things started out poorly in this game, and to be frank, they just really haven't gotten much better.
And all that does is embolden a secondary. They feel good about what's going on, and they just play better.
And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, San Francisco. Carlos Hyde taking it in from 7 yards away. And the 49ers able to get this back to some measure of respectability. And he knocks it through. Gold now out to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take this across the 25, a couple extra yards, up to the 27-yard line. The Panthers offense here, they get ready to head back on the field. And Charles, in a very one-sided affair, I think we've reached the point in the broadcast where you and I, we may have some filling to do, right?
Yeah, I think you're right about that, because we got to try and keep people around. We don't want them to change the channel. Stay with us in this game. Is that Ben Ramsar? Are you hearing from Ben on the headset here? Tell us,
stretch
this thing out a little bit.
Get some talking points. Dig them all out.
That's what you get. A big-time producer, keep them here.
Second down and a little ways to go here. Second and 13. McCaffrey takes it to the 26, just a 1 yard gain.
That gives him 98 yards in this game, and he's got to feel pretty good about that, but the entire offense does. The big thing, though, Brent, they've got to get to 100, though.
You think he knows he's at 98?
I think someone has told him by now, and here's the thing. Getting to 100 or more is tangible evidence that you've had a nice day running the football. And that's what his offensive line wants for him and for themselves.
And down he goes. The 49ers get there.
The game plan for any defense is finding ways to make a quarterback uncomfortable in the pocket. When you bring pressure from all angles, you never know who's going to get home. In this case, the left cornerback, right in the face of him, puts him down.
And this is away. It's a high kick, and he got all of it. And it's taken in at the 9. Well, he wasn't too far from breaking that. Officially, give him 15, and the Niners will go on offense, 1st and 10. Beathard to throw. Under pressure now, and Beathard goes down to the turf. Mario Addison. in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8. And he's able to get out to the 32, brought down there. They get 16 out of that one, but they'll still need to convert on third. Cool under pressure right there, escaping the pocket and finding what I think was not his primary target.
And some of these guys are just so comfortable getting outside of the pocket that they'll do it on purpose. It doesn't even need to be a breakdown. They move. And they know it affects the defense because a lot of times you get lost in coverage in the secondary. And I think you're exactly right. Wasn't his primary target. Found a secondary guy who sprang open, probably because of his movement out of the pocket.
And this is going to be incomplete.
I'm not sure we could spot any tendency here on this third down. They could have run it or passed it. Either one was available. They chose to try and get it through the air, but they were unsuccessful.
A critical one here if they're going to have any shot at this thing. So they'll go for it on fourth down. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And it is incomplete. Boy, it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Panthers are going to get it back in excellent field position. A gutsy decision there at this stage in the second half in their own territory, and a decision that they might regret.
Can't wait for the postmortem. You know, this post-game press conference, because the questions are going to come fast and furious about this decision, no matter how the game turns out, right? What were you thinking there? Why? Did you have a certain play call? Were you confident in your defense? Oh, yeah. Why? It's going to keep coming up.
Yeah, no matter the scoreboard, just tough to justify. They'll run with McCaffrey, and he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. And when do they start thinking about burning these timeouts? They've got all three still defensively.
To me, you have to start right now. Here's the time, and that means you've got to stop them on defense, not give up the yardage, use your timeouts in order to get the ball back and try and score yourself. But now is the time to start using those timeouts.
And keep in mind, it'll also stop the clock at the two-minute warning. And room there to work it inside the 25. 8 yards on the run there, and that leaves them with third and just a couple. The Panthers on third down. They've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 2. They'll need to get the playoff quickly. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And a short gain here, down to the 22. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's 4th down.
This is what happens sometimes when you abandon the running game. It's hard to get back to it because once guys get out of that mentality of firing out and hitting people,
oh, they get to the football. It's blocked. It's picked up. He's got daylight. He's at the 50, the 30, 20, 10. And he's across for the touchdown. Too little, too late. But he does get in for 6.
No wonder you're grinning. You just beat me in our fantasy league.
Indeed I did, my good man.
That's been a tough day, but they finally were able to get one into the end zone, and maybe the offense will feel a little bit better about itself going into next week.
And if you're a coach taking that into next week, I know you're upset, but it is a little bit more respectable, somewhat of a moral victory, right?
Yeah, they probably won't say a lot of that to the team, but it is true. It's something for them to build on, and then they can call their mom and tell her, hey, mom, for your fantasy points, we got you a few down the stretch.
After the touchdown, it's Robbie Gould now to kick it away. This is taken just shy of the 10 here. And he'll take this across the 25. Couple extra yards up to the 27-yard line. Carolina getting set to take the field. And this will probably be the final play before the two-minute warning.
Set. 180.
They start on the ground with McCaffrey. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. Time for a break. Back to finish it off on EA Sports after this. Territory. That good for 22 and a first down.
Do my eyes deceive me, or is he getting stronger as this game moves along?
Burst seems just as good here in the fourth as it was way back in the first, doesn't it?
I do believe someone put a lot of time in the offseason and continues to condition during the season in order to continue to carry the ball at this rate.
Here's McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down right around the 41-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. This run defense was a weakness last year toward the bottom of the league, and early returns not good here this year.
And that's too bad, because you and I both know that when you have something that's a weakness from your team the year before, you spend a lot of time out in the offseason, whether it's personnel, adjustments in scheme, all of those things. So that's got to be disheartening to start off the season this way.
Defense still with 3 timeouts. We'll see if they want to use them here as the kneel down comes. The Panthers on 3rd down, 5 out of 9 thus far. This is 3rd and 4. And partner, this first week, this first game that we get to call together, so special every year, week 1. You had the...
Yeah, pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law. It's a shame, rhyme.
It's a shame they let us jump out of Bentleys with dirty vans. Hit the stage for 15 minutes, get 30 bands. Swiss bank counting clean money with dirty hands. With some hood that's ready to with the. Since I came in, it made my name a name brand. French. Paris clubbing like a caveman. We threw up the pyramids, now they say we Illuminati. I'm a tsunami, what the. It's a little yachty, no blood diamonds, I rock gold like a king. Jewelry so cold, made him blow the nose off the Sphinx. You think I'ma be some type of role model? I go full throttle, desperado, that's the motto. Vic in Chicago, it's you have fit the grotto. Brazilian motto, she mean mugging like Frida Kahlo. Drinking it with an Alicia Machado. I'm the ticket, you just hit the lotto.
Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we know true north.
Oh my goodness.
Smiling with 50 carats in my jaw.
Oh my goodness.
The law. It's a shame, rhyme.
Young Vic the diamonds, finest. I shine like puff shine. Shines up my sign to the rock, cause I'm timeless. Top off the Mozzie, my behavior is mindless. On kids, we major, you mindless. Fresh out the cell to the booth. Drop the roof. I'm still in the hood, tell, shoot. Hope, what up, club. The judge, you rappers is false flagging, you a fashion.
What's cuz, what you know about? What's V-Lo? Why Barry Lee, your head ringing? Free Vic Mensa, I'm a star, chain swinging. This that music, you can blame Reagan. I'm Bob Mayer, without paying. Y'all playing, we playing. My Himalayan. Lotto, that's the sacrificial lamb. I'm season cam, no matter, blam.
Pulling up with the crew.
Oh my goodness.
Must have done same with the roof.
Oh my goodness.
You sitting looking stupid on the stoop.
Oh my goodness.
I would take notes if I were you.
Oh my goodness.
This was designed with the stars, the square and the cross, so we